Well, my understanding is that you took an oath, you raised your right hand here today, and you said that you would solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And now you're not answering questions. You're impeding this investigation. So my understanding of the legal standard is that you either answer the question, that's the best outcome. You say, this is classified, can't answer it here. I'll answer it in closed session. That's bucket number two. Bucket number three is to say, I'm invoking executive privilege. There is no appropriateness bucket. It is not a legal standard. Can you tell me what are these longstanding DOJ rules that protect conversations made in the executive without invoking executive privilege?
Senator, I'm protecting the president's constitutional right by not giving it away before he has a chance to
view it.
And secondly, I am telling the truth in answering your question in saying it's a longstanding policy of the Department of Justice.
Are those policies written?
Even and to make sure the president has full opportunity to decide these issues.
Can you share those policies with us? Are they written down at the Department of Justice?
I believe they are.
This is the appropriateness legal standard for not answering congressional inquiries.
It's my judgment that it would be inappropriate for me to answer and reveal private conversations with the president when he has not had a full opportunity to review the questions and to make a decision on whether or not to approve such an answer. One, there are also other privileges that could be invoked. One of the things deals with the investigation of the special counsel.
We're not asking questions about that investigation. If I wanted to ask questions about that investigation, I'd ask those of Rod Rosenstein. I'm asking about your personal knowledge from this committee, which has a constitutional obligation to get to the bottom of this. There are two investigations here. There is a special counsel investigation. There is also a congressional investigation. And you are obstructing that congressional investigation by not answering these questions. And I think your silence, like the silence of Director Coates, like the silence of Admiral Rogers, speaks volumes.
I would say that I have consulted with senior career attorneys in the department,
I suspect
and they believe
you have.
This is consistent with my duty.